Alright, so, if you haven't already, cell phones, cameras, all that stuff. But enjoy the show. Thank you, guys. Thank you, guys. Once upon a time, there was
a... I had to go to the bathroom.
All right, let's go. Than to use these mysterious pebbles
as the lighthouse to guide him home. So he collected as many as he could and crept back to his sister.
Oh, brother, why are you about at such a late hour?
Shh, be comforted, little sister, and sleep in peace. God will not forsake us.
Deeper into the forest than they had ever been before.
Right here in the woods.
What? No! No, that was our bread for our trail home! Why would you just eat bread off of the ground?
What?
What?
You used our only food to make a breadcrumb trail home? I thought that you were running away. I thought you were coming with me.
It was just in case we needed it.
Oh, just in case. Hansel, that is just like you. You take shit from everybody.
Well, it's gone now, so what difference does it make?
So, why in the woods?
Well, for your information, Mr. Feel Everything, our parents don't have enough food to feed us, so we ran away from home, and, you know, even if we wanted to go back, it's not like we could now, because you ate our breadcrumb trail, so we're stuck out here forever and ever.
Wow. Bummer. So, why would you want to go back to a place like that anyway?
Ding, ding, ding! Thank you! That is why I had the idea to run away in the first place.
You know what? Who are you to say? You know, things might be tough at home, but it doesn't mean I can just forget about them. You know, and last time I checked, you're out here in the woods, just like us.
Yeah, because I'm looking for the tree of life.
Really? Out here?
Might as well. Don't really have much of a choice.
Why not?
Well, there's this princess.
Oh, princess, great.
No, you don't understand.
Can I explain?
Well, it's kind of a long story.
Well, we have a little while since you ate our way home.
All right. So, a couple years ago, I was the servant to this king. But he wasn't just any king, he was the best king. And it wasn't because he was rich, and it wasn't because he was powerful, but it was because he had knowledge more than anything in the world. But nobody knew where he had gotten this knowledge. Now, one day, after the tables had been cleared in the hall and the guests had been ushered from their spots, I was given the dignified task of bringing in the king's secret silver platter. Now, up until this point, nobody knew what was under that platter, but tonight I was feeling curious, and the king had stepped out of the hall for a minute, so I looked around, and I lifted the lid, and what did I find but a giant white snake? Now I knew where the king had gained his excellent knowledge. I'm peacing out of the kingdom.
I shall be a servant
no longer.
He ain't gonna serve you, man. He ain't gonna serve you no more.
A white snake. The sensations of the forest were unlike anything Jacob had ever experienced before. The blues were bluer. The greens were greener, and the reds were... crap, this is crap. Under the influence of the white snake, the world that you've never seen before, the prince of the world is blurry. It was a whole new world. A new fantastic point of view. And Jacob couldn't get enough. As he walked along the forest path, he soon came to a stream and, oh yeah, the fish. He remembered his great thirst and looked into the clear water and saw two fish struggling in a net. The fish called out to Jacob, saying,
Excuse
me, my dear old brother, you need help.
Allow me to assist you.
Oh, oh. Ah!
him, he came to a sand path. And although it's strange to find a sand path in the middle of a forest, he traveled on it anyway. Not long after continuing on his way, he began to hear what sounded like teeny tiny voices coming from the ground beneath him. He listened hard and looked down. There he saw thousands and thousands of ants scurrying about. And in the center of the ants was an ant king, calling out to him and saying,
"Stranger, what do you do?"
"Excuse me, are you the ant king?" "I'm king."
"I am the great ant king, Mick Abernathy Barrack. And this is my ant kingdom."
"Excuse me, how do you do? I was just crossing this path, you see."
"You were crossing this path? You and your monstrously huge feet are destroying my fair land!"
"Oh, I apologize. But I'm on a journey and I must continue on my way."
"Well, as long as you're apologetic, I suppose we're fine. Listen, if you care for the ones that crawl beneath your feet, you will gently step over my kingdom."
"Yes. Yes, anything you say."
"Here we go." "Okay, I'm ready." "Oh, God! Oh, Lord! My tiny, tiny ant ear! Oh, it's so loud! It hurts! Oh, my skull!
I'm done!
Oh,
I'm done! I'm done!"
"Oh, what? Huh?
Finish!
What? Oh,
finish!
It's over! Oh, well, stranger, even though I'm dead, thank you! You have spared my kingdom. Remember, sir, one good deed deserves another. We shall meet again. Now, frolly my ants!"
And there again was that strange phrase. But Jacob again didn't dwell on it and continued on his way. Soon he lost track of the path altogether, and the forest grew deeper and darker. He tripped on a root and felt the earth. The vines snarled up around him and he was caught. Branches snapped by his ears. Jacob was terrified. He felt helpless. But just as he was about to give up, he gathered all his strength and all his courage and burst forth from the forest floor. He soon found his way again. He then heard a mother raven screaming and shrieking at her children like a banshee.
One good deed deserves another.
Well, after that, it interesting meal we both shared. Perhaps you could point me out of the forest.
Oh, sure, that's well.
Yeah, dude, there's a city like right over there. Come on, we'll show you. Sure. I think I'm strong enough to fly now.
Me too.
Are you ready? Let's go!
Let's do it!
And so the ravens led Jacob to the city. Once there, he saw in the center of the square a beautiful princess. He immediately fell in love with her. And lucky for Jacob, a contest was being held that very day for the princess's hand in marriage. In order to win, he would have to retrieve a gold ring that had been thrown into the sea. However, if he did not complete this task, he would be thrown into the sea again and again and again and again until he drowned. All of the townspeople mourned for this young youth, for he would surely not be able to complete this impossible task. Then they went away. Jacob, too, was weary. He walked down to the shore and gazed into the water, not knowing what to do. Then he saw two fishes swim towards him, and these were the very fishes that he had helped earlier that day. One of them had a seashell in his mouth, and it placed it at Jacob's feet. And inside was the gold ring that he sought. Jacob was so excited, he hurriedly brought the ring to the king, expecting to get the princess's hand in marriage immediately. However, upon seeing that Jacob was not an equal to her in birth, she scorned him and said, "You will not be my husband until you complete another task." And she strewn 10 bags of grain into the grass, saying, "I will not wed you until you pick up every grain and place it back into these bags." Again, Jacob was weary, for he surely would not be able to complete this task. He fell asleep. The next morning he woke up, expecting to be led to his death. But instead, he saw that all 10 bags of grain were full of grain. The ant king had come in the night, and with his thousands and thousands of ants, they had helped Jacob fill the bags. Now Jacob would surely get the princess's hand in marriage. But she could still not conquer her proud heart. She scorned him again, saying, "This time, I will not marry you until you bring me an apple from the tree of life." Jacob did not know where the tree of life stood, but he set out.
So that's why I'm in the woods.
I'm so sorry. Excuse me. Thank you for clearing that up. Because I was strictly under the impression that you were just out here to eat our way home. You know, here comes the breadcrumb monster. That looks pretty good. Is that right? I'm going to eat there.
Hansel!
I don't care about that.
Hansel! There's enough with the breadcrumbs, okay? It's getting dark, so we should probably just stay here for the night. Maybe build a fire. Hansel.
I don't know how to do that.
Well, I could build us a fire if you'd let me camp with you for the night.
I'm okay with it.
Fine.
Alright. Here we go. Try a little bit of the white snake.
Excuse me?
I mean, it's really not bad for you, man. I mean, the king ate it all the time. Look, he's fine.
I don't know. I don't feel like mother and father would want us to play. Incredible!
What? You're not gonna let me try it by myself, are you?
No.
Cheers. Stars like this when I lived in the kingdom.
Oh.
Look, there's a turtle.
Oh, look, there's an owl.
Look, that one looks like a doe.
Doe? Huh.
Yeah, that's your doe.
Mine?
Yeah.
I like it.
Me too. Well, it is getting late. We should go to bed. We have a long day tomorrow. Yeah. Good night.
Good night.
Thank you.
Oh, I'm, take it off, man. See you later.
Excuse me. You're just gonna leave?
Yeah. See ya.
You're not even gonna say goodbye?
Oh, sorry, man. See ya. Good luck.
Tree of life, right?
Yeah.
And not for yourself. No, but for this princess, right? Who doesn't even like you. Who won't take you as her husband, even after you completed all of her tasks. And she doesn't appreciate you at all.
Well, yeah, but I mean, did you see that shadowy thing?
She's beautiful. So you're looking for the tree of life. The almighty tree that binds all creation together, so that you might get laid. Seriously?
Well, you're not much better. Why would you want to go back to such a crap hole anyway?
You're poor, you have no food, and your parents hate you and want to kill you. You don't belong out here.
Why don't you just go home?
At least he's not a servant boy who still lives to serve others.
You know what? I don't know you. I don't have to prove anything. I'm out of here.
Hello, Jacob.
You know my name.
We've been watching you.
How old are you? Like six?
We're older than you think.
Where's your parents?
We left our parents behind too. We're just like you, I'm so
stood here.
What witchcraft be this? Whoa! I'm afraid of what might happen if we don't let each other go. Who knows what we might
you know, and it's not so bad. I mean, I'll have my own room now, so that's pretty cool. You know, maybe at least we'll have enough food for all, for me.
What about this?
You sure?
I am.
Here, take this.
How will you fight your wrinkles?
Be comforted, little sister. I'll think of something.
Hansel found his way home. And he did, Miss Gretel. Very much. After everything he'd seen, and after everything he'd been through, home just wasn't the same. And there was a part of him that would always be out in the woods. And that was okay.